Previously on Hell's Kitchen.
I don't have any friends in this house.
It's not about being friends, it's about professionalism.
Having survived elimination.
Yeah, my modest no, but I'm a winner.
Elise was on the warpath.
Yes, I have a big mouth, and I'm not gonna stop now.
The next day, the retro cooking challenge.
Back to basics. Fire and water.
Proved too much for Monterey.
I'm stumped right now.
The heart.
But a critical mistake by Krupa.
That, madam, is not veal. That's filet mignon.
Handed the blue team another challenge win.
Well done.
At dinner service.
Monterey!
A disoriented Monterey had problems on the meat.
Hey, Bozo, that is raw.
But he wasn't the only one lost in the blue kitchen.
Tommy!
So Chef Ramsay had no choice but to show them the way out.
Get out of here, both of you. Fuck off upstairs.
In the red kitchen.
1 minute on those scallops.
Slow it down a little bit.
Welcome with my scallops.
Gina was out for herself.
I can walk with my entrees now.
What? You're not walking. Okay, whatever.
Sinking Elise.
I don't have everything.
That really screwed me.
And ending both ladies' dinner service early.
Fuck off. Both of you, fuck off upstairs.
Then, Chef Ramsay had a message for everyone.
You're going backwards.
And both teams had to nominate two people. The blue team chose...
Monterey.
And...
Tommy.
The red team chose...
Krupa.
And...
Elise.
Elise.
I'm not the weakest.
Who is?
Gina is the weakest.
Elise, I agree with you. Gina, take your jacket off. Get out of Hell's Kitchen.
And that would be the end of Gina's dream of becoming head chef at BLT Steak in New York City. And now, the continuation of Hell's Kitchen.
Good night!
Now I need you to get somewhere in between being a mouse and being an old mouse, okay? You promise?
I promise, I can do this. I'm trying to work on my attitude and my weaknesses and my flaws. I've definitely become more humble here. I'm supposed to be here, yo.
Oh! Did your heart drop again?
Oh, yes! What? I'm gonna kill him! Fucking pump! I'm so relieved. I'm so fucking relieved.
It's a little offensive the way Elise reacted. She's not a very humble person, so it wasn't surprising to me for her to be like a cheerleader when she came back.
She's so happy. I don't think this is a reason to be happy.
No.
We lost. Gina just got sent home without even defending herself. It's not really a time to be celebrating. Seriously, just shut up.
I'm still here.
After a miserable performance at dinner last night, the chefs are eager for a shot at redemption.
Let's go, ladies.
And Chef Ramsay is happy to give them one.
New day, new beginning. Everybody is starting with a clean slate. Because for the first time in Hell's Kitchen, we are going to be hosting a high school reunion.
Oh, no. Wow. I loved high school. We had no worries. It's where I met all my best friends. I wish I could go back to high school.
Culver City class of 1991. Excited?
Yes, Chef. Yes, Chef.
I was not a big fan of high school. Everyone that says it's the best years of your life have never been to college.
Okay, listen carefully. Upstairs in my office are three reunion committee members. And we're gonna have a private discussion with them on what they'd like to see on their menu. From the red team, I would like Elizabeth. And from the blue team, Paul. Let's go.
Seriously, Elizabeth, she really is a space cadet. You'll say something to Elizabeth and it's like a 30-second delay. It's like, what, huh? I wonder if anyone's home sometimes.
You got it, Paulie. Come on, buddy.
Come on, Paulie.
Go blue. Paul's a great cook. Paul knows what he's doing. I have nothing but faith and confidence in Paul.
Ladies, hello.
Hi.
May I introduce you to Paul and Elizabeth.
Hi.
So, first of all, we're very honoured to host this special event. Do you have a theme, an idea in mind?
We were thinking maybe we could recreate something Hawaiian, a luau. That would be fun.
I would definitely love to see some pork, something more hearty.
I would love to see some scallops.
I haven't done a lot of like Hawaiian cooking and stuff, but I've done like Asian, and they do taste extremely similar.
I'm a pescatarian, so I only eat fish.
Okay.
How do you guys feel about combining meat and seafood on the same plate? Like a surf and turf.
Not for me.
I think Elizabeth kind of daydreams a lot, or she doesn't pay attention. She just said that she doesn't eat meat. Elizabeth's in La La Land.
Any more questions?
No, I think I've got a concept.
Okay, we're going to get cooking. Thank you for that insight. We'll see you shortly, yes?
Chef Ramsay's Tasting Menu Challenge will not only test the team's creativity, but Paul and Elizabeth's ability to listen and communicate.
Paul and Elizabeth, you've got all the information you need. You've got 45 minutes, and your time starts now. Off you go.
Now, it's up to Elizabeth and Paul to convey the committee's preferences to their teams.
Okay, so they definitely said they wanted Asian, so I would definitely want to do appetizer. Bacon wrapped, like scallops, is really nice.
Why don't we do a roasted pork tenderloin sliced?
I think that sounds really nice.
The Asian lentils would look cool, too.
I think lentils is nicer with pork.
I don't know where the lentils came from. They're not Asian. I was confused as to if she really did have the right details or not.
So I feel good about this.
It's a good idea.
This is what they want. They want to do a Hawaiian theme.
Okay. Yeah.
They also want pork.
Okay. And we got a good tenderloin right here.
You do like a pineapple or mango chutney for the pork.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Do like a fish surf and turf.
One of the ladies can't eat meat at all. Maybe make like a crab sauce for the fish.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Okay. We should start cooking.
Each team must create and prepare a tasting menu consisting of one appetizer, one meat entree, and one seafood entree.
We gotta get the pork in the oven and start the lentils.
Okay, I'll grab the lentils.
The winning dishes will be featured on the high school reunion's menu.
So I got the guava, I got the lime.
What else is after this?
Put some chilies in there.
Chilies?
Yeah.
What else?
Some sugar, some vinegar.
Yes?
Yeah, like make a chutney. Monterey, you need to know what you're making. Pay attention. You shouldn't have to ask us every 7 seconds, what goes with this or what goes with that?
What I'm doing to this pineapple is breaking it down right now.
Yeah, you need to know, man. This is it. Put up or shut up. Let's go. Come on, Monty.
The fuck? What a spoon is that?
While Monterey struggles to stay focused, over in the red kitchen, Carrie is very focused.
I'm gonna dice this up for the avocado.
On her own ideas.
We can do a little bit of orange zest.
No, I always
do zest.
I'm not feeling that.
Really?
Yeah, I kind of took charge, but I'm not bossy. I'm always willing to let other people put their ideas in as well. Tuna right here, next to it, a little avocado. Then we're gonna do the stick up.
Can I make a suggestion? What if we do them so they go sideways?
Nah, I want the hive. Yeah?
So far, I've had the most success working by myself. So for me to pair up with Flirty Bimbo.
I'm excited. I am.
And jive on the same dish. I wasn't feeling it.
Don't worry, I got this. I make this all the time at home.
Just under 2 minutes to go.
Yes, chef. Oh, I dropped the scallop, Jamie. Well, we got four ones to work with.
That's it?
Will, you got the red salt?
I got red salt here.
I'm getting the bacon pieces on it.
Holy.
We got this.
Croutons.
You put the nuts on top?
For the what on top?
The nuts.
Five,
no, there's no nuts.
Four,
sorry.
Three, two, one, and serve. Okay, I'd like to introduce you to three amazing ladies that are here to choose who's got the best dishes. Jenna, Diada, and Lynn.
Hi.
Ladies, please take a seat. We've got a wonderful tasting menu for you. The theme is Hawaii.
What the hell? I didn't hear anything about Hawaiian. It was Asian. I don't know where she came up with Asian.
Appetizers, let's go.
Go, boo.
Are you kidding me? They wanted Hawaiian? We're gonna look like idiots going up there with these Japanese dishes.
Okay, Natalie.
It is ahi tuna and ono. Poke, it's traditionally Hawaiian. I have it on a freshly toasted crostini. Wanted something to be really easy to eat.
Diana?
I had the perfect bite. You hit it on the head for me.
I really enjoy the consistency of the fish. I think it's great.
Thank you.
Good start. Thank you, Natalie.
Nailed it.
We have a tuna tartare that we put our own little spin on. Ahi tuna with the avocado that we mix some chilies with. On top, you have the wonton. Please enjoy.
Lynn.
I absolutely love the tuna.
I think the guacamole is a little bit overpowering.
We
That's
can lighten
all
up on
I
that.
Tasted.
Yeah, we can lighten up on that.
Carrie, shut the fuck up.
For me, the fish and the guacamole, I like them each separately. I don't know about together. But okay. Maybe a little.
Well, whatever y'all want, we can work
heavy.
Out for you.
But hey, I thought the flavors were amazing.
Carrie, would you be kind to at least let
Alex,
madam, I'd like to hear it's constructive feedback.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Carrie does need to learn when to shut up. Shut the fuck up right now, Carrie, because I will strangle you myself.
Jenna, what do you think, darling? Red or blue?
I think I'm going to have to go with the blue.
I'm going to be agreeing with Jenna on this one.
I agree. The blue. Okay.
Damn.
Congratulations. 1 point to the blue.
Thank you so much, ladies.
Thank you.
I can't believe I got beat out by a crostini.
Damn it.
Meats, please.
With Natalie giving the blue team the early lead, it's now time for Krupa and Monterey to face off with the meat entrees.
Okay, Krupa.
We have a nut-crusted pork loin. There's some delicious lentils with a little bit of blanched bok choy on the side.
How was that?
I mean, it tasted delicious, but I don't know that I felt like it was a Hawaiian-themed dish.
Yeah, I think of Hawaii, I don't think of lentils. Monterey.
Here we have a roasted tenderloin. On top, we have a mango pineapple chutney.
The pork dish was the dish I was most concerned about. Monterey's chutney was gonna be the wild card. I hope we get this right. I hope the pork's cooked.
Are you sending the ladies on a diet? Where's the rest of the dish?
We're just thinking, you know, light, but, you know, a little fulfilling.
That's really, it's worth a small portion.
It's worth a small portion. Thank you, ma'am.
It's very tasty.
Mm.
I need another bite.
I mean, it's really good. Ladies, I don't think I have to ask.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Point to the blue team. Good job.
Thank you, Chef.
I am so sick of losing. Like, I hate losing. I hate it.
Monterey, now I know the secret to your cooking is sit three ladies in front of you. Fish, please. Let's see if the blue team can make a clean sweep of it. Let's start off with ladies first, please. Wow, look at that.
Looks amazing.
We have barbecue seared scallops, and the barbecue sauce is guavo chipotle, finished with bacon lardons. I hope you enjoy it, ladies.
Did you say bacon?
Yes, bacon lardons.
Okay. I'll have to pass on this one.
I'm sorry. Is bacon inside the sauce? Or?
Yeah, the bacon is inside the sauce.
Okay.
And you really wanted the scallop.
It's okay.
Elizabeth, Diada did explain that she's a pescatarian and she couldn't eat meat.
I'm a pescatarian. I can't eat it because it got bacon in it. And I kind of looked at Elizabeth like, oh, no, you didn't.
Did you forget?
Oh, my God, Elizabeth.
Just asking. Oh, Jesus.
Okay, I'm sorry. I was under the impression that, like, we could mix them. I'm sorry. How do you guys feel about combining meat and seafood on the same plate, like a surf and turf?
I know.
Elizabeth gave us the wrong ingredients. You gave us the wrong theme. You gave us all, everything was wrong.
Jenna, how was that?
Well, I'm gonna have to admit I'm not a big scallop person.
Wow.
I honestly just didn't care for it that much. It's too barbecue-y. I thought maybe it was a little undercooked.
Yeah, scallops could have been done with a touch more cooking, especially the one I ate. Will, give us some delight, please.
For your fish course, we have a banana leaf wrapped steamed opa. Opa is also known as Hawaiian moonfish. And the sauce is a coconut chili lime mayo sauce.
Oh my gosh. Mm. Yeah, this is delish.
Gorgeous.
It's pretty.
Gorgeous.
Yeah.
Wow. Amazing. Come on. I don't want to stop eating. Amazing.
Delicious.
Kind of takes your palate on a little bit of a journey. Wow.
Like, it's really flavorful. It hits you. I still think about it afterwards. I feel it in my mouth.
Good job.
Thank you very much.
Ladies, again, I think it's pretty obvious.
Yes.
Blue team, congratulations. Great job. 3-0. A shutout. Well done.
Thank you, Chef.
Great job.
I mean, we just got spanked. So bad. I'm tired of losing. I'm not a loser.
Thanks for coming. Lynn, good to see you, darling.
Thank you.
It's a night to remember, yes?
I'm frustrated because it feels like Elizabeth wore earplugs during her briefing because she didn't bring back none of the right information. And we all look like idiots.
All right, Paul, great brief.
Thank you, Chef. It feels amazing to have a clean sweep, but it even feels more amazing that I led us to a clean sweep.
So I have an amazing reward for you. You'll be spending the day on a magnificent super yacht.
What?
It's got four levels.
Yay!
It has a jacuzzi.
Wow.
A fully stocked bar.
Yeah.
Trust me, you are going to have an amazing day on the water.
I really needed this win. It's like fireworks going off inside of me right now. It's like, man.
Up to the dorm. Congratulations.
Yes.
Great job. Well done.
Thank you, Chef.
Enjoy.
Oh.
Ladies, you're in for a busy day. Let me tell you that. You'll be working to redecorate and transform Hell's Kitchen into an Hawaiian theme ahead of that wonderful dinner.
Yes, Chef.
Yes, Chef.
But first, it's time to start cleaning. Let's go.
I'm really sick of this shit. I don't know where all this shit came up with that we made, because that's not even what they wanted.
She definitely said Asian, I know 100%.
But you pressed the issue of bacon.
And they said they wanted pork. We want pork. So I said, go with bacon.
But if she was a pescatarian, I'm sure she mentioned it, and that was something that should have been told to the team, because we would all know that we can't put bacon on
it. I'm not going to take all the blame for this when we lost by a landslide. Can't blame the whole thing on me. Everybody lost points, and not because of the information I said, just because, like, the dishes were not good enough. Your scallops were undercooked. The leaf.
Bitch.
While the red team plays the blame game, the blue team is ready to party on the boat.
That ain't a boat, bitch. That's a yacht.
This is awesome. Woo-hoo. This is the best reward ever.
What? I get a captain's hat?
You get a camera?
It's a waterproof digital camera.
Waterproof.
Yay! Hey, guys, real quick. You guys look like the village people.
That looks like David Lee Roth.
Right?
Hey.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Paul is on the yacht.
This is what it feels like to be better than everybody else.
I'm cheers to that.
Yes.
That's what I'm talking about.
As the blue team sets sail, back in Hell's Kitchen, the red team does some heavy lifting.
Let's go.
Oh, fuck.
This is heavy. Pick it up.
But not everyone is pulling their weight.
It's heavy.
Are they heavy, Jamie?
Yes.
Oh, that one's lighter.
You got the whole thing?
Yep. That's heavy.
As usual, Elisa's kind of standing there, you know, not really doing anything, just kind of talking.
Oh, that one's real heavy.
That's how Elisa is. She's good at pretending she's doing something when she's really not.
Somebody want to give me a hand?
Drag it.
Damn.
While the red team seems to have had enough of Elise, the blue team can't seem to get enough of Natalie.
Nice smile on the yacht, baby. Can't beat that.
Can't beat that, baby.
Nice. This is where it's at, man. They don't get no better than this.
We pitched the perfect game.
I feel like a movie star right now. I kind of came in as a supporting cast in the blue team, and I feel like that I kind of brought everyone together.
At first, I was totally against another person coming over to our crew, but
I'm happy with that.
Okay, Natalie came over, the bench team died, and the blue team flies.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
They give me a lot of respect, and I know all my team has my back.
Yeah, hey.
Oh, I get a picture of Natalie.
Back in Hell's Kitchen, the girls have been making luau leis for hours.
How many do you think you've gotten done of those leis?
19.
Oh, my God. What a relaxing day. I drank so much wine.
I can't understand anything they're saying.
I'm the king of the world.
We walk in, and the red team's sitting there at the table making leis. They look miserable, so why not rub it in a little bit?
The hot tub is so comfortable.
Get off of me.
Comfortable.
Go ahead.
Whoa. But you know what I got? This cool waterproof camera.
Natalie's junk.
We'll show you all the pictures. It was so fun. We'd all had some drinks. We were all having a really good time. And sucks for the red team, but, you know, what can you do? Hey, will you take a picture of me standing in, like, the flower garden?
I'll take a picture of you whenever. Absolutely.
Ah.
Oh, shit. It's definitely interesting to see Natalie a little tipsy. Why don't you take Natalie deserves it. Natalie worked hard. We all worked hard. It's cool to see Natalie letting her hair down.
I wish I could have got the splash, man. That was a classic. That would have been beautiful.
Now.
Sexy.
I think a lot of the guys on the blue team, you know, they miss their wives, they miss their girlfriends, and they really love having me on the team. And honestly, I appreciate all the comments they make and wanting to take pictures of me.
Yo, why don't you take the yellow thing off for right here?
You should have been a model, not a cook.
I modeled for a while.
I can tell. Give me a good one. You ready? Give me a good one on 3, 2, 1. Yes.
Morning comes quickly, and the chefs must get an early start prepping for tonight's first ever high school reunion dinner service. But after yesterday's indulgent day on the high seas,
how you feeling?
Oh no.
Gross.
The blue team is moving a little slow.
Yep.
And the red team is working on their final punishment task.
So is it good cake?
I'm working on it.
Putting together a three-layer cake.
Yeah. I've never put a cake this big together. We have to pick this shit up and put it on top of this. Oh my God.
You need another hand, set of hands?
Oh, it's here, right in the middle. Oh.
Move it.
This is gonna be the worst cake ever.
This cake's gonna be a freaking joke because nobody's taking this seriously. Am I the only one that cares?
All right, can we have like a team meeting for 5 seconds?
This cake's gonna look like shit and it's not funny.
Who's laughing? Stop saying that like no one's taking this seriously. Carrie got a big mouth as always and she wanna try to get in my face with it. She better back down.
No, I wasn't saying that, I was making
that's
a joke.
That's exactly what you said. You said no. No one's laughing either. Like that to other people makes them feel as though they're not taking
okay,
that seriously.
I'm not trying to make anyone
okay,
feel inferior.
I'm just telling you what you said.
At least can I
and
please
you definitely
talk
don't make
for
me inferior.
One?
You don't make me feel inferior. I just don't like how you try to act like no one else around you is taking
blah,
it seriously.
Blah, 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 blah. Blah, 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 blah. Carrie, blah, 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 blah.
You're a trifling ass bitch.
Are you kidding me?
I'm about to show you, bitch. Everyone's
you don't
taking
have to
serious.
Yell at me. I'm right
You better
here.
Get out of my face.
Blah, 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 blah.
God I know that.
Fucking
you better
a.
get up out of my face.
Honestly, I just don't get trashy like that. That's not my style. Freaking drama.
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
It's ironic that we're prepping for high school reunion and Elise and Carrie are like two high school girls wanting to rip each other's hair out and accomplishing nothing. So we're screwed. That's what we're stuck with.
I think it looks like shit.
Why don't we just cover it up with a fucking bunch of flowers?
We're gonna need a lot
That's
of decorations
only thing I think
for
we
this.
Can
All right, then somebody needs to just work on decorations. Someone make a lot of fucking decorations.
I'll start working on flowers.
Okay.
With the reunion just minutes away.
Everyone cool? Everyone knows what they're doing?
All right, let's clean it up.
The decorations are all falling off.
Hi, guys.
Morning, Chef.
Chef Ramsay wants to make sure everything is in order.
Let's go. Big, big, big night. Our first ever high school reunion. Red team, ladies.
Yes, Chef.
That looks amazing. Wow. Well done.
Thank you, Chef.
Where's the cake? Please. Scott, we ordered the special stand for the cake, right?
Yes.
Okay, good. Excellent. What on earth? Holy crap. Did someone vomit on it? What's all the bits of brown at the bottom? What's that?
We thought it would look like sand.
Look at it. It's like a big Mexican sombrero gone wrong when someone shat on it.
Oh, God.
Blue team, have you seen this disaster?
Olay.
Yeah. let me tell you something. We are definitely not serving that thing. Do you mind, Scott? Do you mind just putting that over there? Or...
Thank you.
I hope you did a much better job preparing the blue team's winning dishes, yes?
Yes,
please
chef.
Please tell me you did that. Okay, let's go.
Yes, chef.
Okay, James, open Hell's Kitchen, please. Let's go.
Yes, chef.
You look ridiculous.
It's honestly. A Hawaiian night.
Yeah, I gather it's Hawaiian night, but honestly.
Can I open?
Yes, James.
At least once a year, Chef Ramsay tests the chefs by closing Hell's Kitchen for a special event. Tonight is a Hawaiian-themed high school reunion, and everyone is hoping it will be a night to remember.
I'm so glad to see you guys.
That's the 91.
I haven't seen you guys since 10 years, right?
Ready to rock this bitch. Blue team, here we go. 2 crab, 2 tuna, 1 shrimp, 1 potstick.
Yes, yes, yes.
I really feel like tonight, the blue team, we're gonna knock it out the park. I mean, we got this menu down. It's our dishes. We're gonna take it in service tonight. Stay focused. Let's go.
Okay, red team, here we go. 2 potstickers, 1 crab, 1 tuna.
Yes, yes, yes.
Why is there garlic on this? What's the garlic going?
Hey, what the shit is this? The blue team's totally at an advantage. All 3 of their dishes are on the menu tonight. So it scares me because the red team doesn't know how to make these dishes.
Wait, are you doing the shrimp sauce or I'm doing it? I thought I was doing it up here.
While the red team tries to find their footing, the blue team seems to be off to a strong start.
How long, please?
I need 4 minutes, Chef.
4 minutes heard.
Good.
Me and Dan, Natalie, we all rocking, pushing out the apps.
Are you coming up?
Yup, I'm right behind you. Go. This is going to be easy, easy money, and we're going to walk out this kitchen victorious.
Thanks to Monterey and Natalie on appetizers.
Service, please. Let's go.
The blue team is humming along.
There you go. Thank you.
And satisfying their reunion guests. Meanwhile, the red team is eager to start sending food as well.
Walking with my salad. I'm not walking yet.
Maybe a little too eager.
Carrie, did you just walk your apps up?
Yes, I did. It's okay, though. I've got 2 pot stickers with that.
It's okay, it's our salad.
Pot stickers, how long?
I need 2 minutes, Chef.
Why can't everything come up together?
I don't know if they didn't hear me or...
So they just went to the window without you?
Yes, Chef.
Carrie has a tendency to want to, like, make herself look good, and some of the mistakes she makes shows how much of a rookie she is. It's like neck and neck with Carrie and Krupa, who's the weakest.
I asked you to work as a team.
Everything else will come out together from now on, Chef.
Oh, fuck off, will you? Here you go. As far as I'm concerned, you can fuck off. Start again.
Yes, Chef.
While the red team struggles to get out appetizers, the blue team has moved on to entrees.
Where's the snapper? Hurry up, guys, please, yes?
I'm walking to the patch right now. Watch your back, watch your back.
Paul?
Yes, Chef.
It's cold in the center, and it's fucking
raw. Yes, Chef,
raw.
Hold your fire, Chef.
I'm struggling, Paul. I don't expect that from you. It's our first table. I'm struggling, Paul. I don't expect that from you. Not tonight!
Yes, Chef. This is my fault. I fucked up. I'm taking this 100% on my shoulders.
Is that a total refire?
Yes.
Guys, we gotta pick this up.
While the blue team starts over on their first set of entrees.
Is it going?
Yes, Chef.
The red team is still struggling to get out appetizers.
Is there any teamwork?
Yes, Chef.
Call back the next table. Call back the next table.
2 shrimp.
Oh, fuck. Who's gonna lead the red team?
I am, Chef.
Let's go then.
Let's go, ladies. 2 pot stickers, salad, and 1 shrimp.
Let's go.
Walking with shrimp.
I see myself as a natural born leader. I do have a big mouth, but I know how to use it.
30 seconds on my pot sticker.
30 seconds, per.
Walking with my salad, following with pot stickers.
We can do this.
And nice to cook, though. Beautiful.
Good job, ladies. That's right. That means I don't just talk. Keep up the communication. I can back it up. You know what I'm saying.
Service, please.
Thanks to Elise's leadership, the red team's reunion guests are finally enjoying their appetizers.
It looks good.
Yeah, the pot sticker's good.
Meanwhile, over in the blue kitchen...
3 open, 1 snapper, 1 pork, 1 New York strip.
Yes, Chef! Yes,
Chef. Let's go.
Monterey decides to lend a helping hand.
We need broccolini. Just use the same pan.
Got it. After I was done apps, I immediately jumped on the garnish. You know, I just went full throttle. What pan is this? What's this?
That is for your broccolini.
You just put broccolini in the cold pan. It's gonna get all greasy. All... Rule number 1. Vegetables in a cold pan with cold oil turns them into what?
Mush, Chef.
Start again.
Yes, Chef.
I want to see some respect. And now you just put it in the trash.
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, my fucking God, you fucking kidding me. It's really embarrassing.
I need you at your best. Use your brain.
Yes, Chef.
While Monterey starts over on his broccolini, over in the red kitchen.
Fish in the window, rice, garnish, let's go.
I need rice. I'm running low. I got it.
Carrie is hoping to impress Chef Ramsay with her speed.
Carrie, look at me. Look at me!
Yes, Chef.
Are you adding the old rice into the fresh rice and just reheating it? I'm watching everything you're doing.
No, I did add the old one. Yes, I'll start over right now.
Dump that pan and start over.
She wants to cut corners, and you wonder why I'm pissed off.
No, Chef. That's pretty stupid. My mind was blown. I was like, well, Chef Ramsay sees her for who she is, the weakest on the team.
I know the name of your restaurant, Shea Leftovers.
Yes, Chef.
While Carrie starts from square one on her rice, Chef Ramsay...
Snapper, please!
...is waiting on Paul.
Where's the snapper?
Once again.
Yes, Chef, I'm pushing it out right now.
It's fucking raw. All of you! I'm struggling! The fish is fucking raw! It's the second time! And it's the committee's table! You can't do that to me.
Chef.
Paul's crashing and burning on the fish station. Like the Titanic, you know? It's fucking going down.
You! Office! Fuck! Jonathan, Monterey, on the fish.
And I'm like, okay.
Come on, let's go, let's go.
Get a grip, guys.
1 more 5 minutes.
Jesus Christ.
While Jonathan and Monterey try to rescue the Blue Kitchen, over in the Red Kitchen, Elizabeth is ready to prove that she is more than capable on the fish station.
Fish to the window.
Yeah, Chef. I want my performance to be absolutely perfect, especially after the really embarrassing challenge. Like, I have got to redeem myself.
Elizabeth.
Yes, Chef.
That's beautifully cooked, the snapper.
Thank you, Chef. Thank you.
You and I, we're on the same page?
I am on the same
Good.
Page.
Good, let's go then.
While the Red Kitchen's dishes are now a hit with Red diners,
go Red team.
Over on the Blue side of the dining room,
I do apologize. It's being recooked.
The reunion committee has yet to receive a single snapper.
Jonathan, Monterey, committee table. We've got to pull it together.
2 minutes.
2 minutes, Chef.
Jump in.
Do you need help?
You do what you gotta do.
No.
Just do what you gotta do.
Chef Ramsey throws me on fish station, so I do what I can. And Jonathan is sitting back and watching. I'm like, dude, what the hell are you doing? Start fucking cooking for your team, please? Like, what is wrong with you?
What the fuck is Jonathan doing?
I'm trying to help, Chef. I'm just trying to help.
Jonathan's sitting in the corner like some stray dog with his tail between his legs.
If anybody needs anything, just holler at me, okay?
So I guess I'm by myself. I have to step up. And I'm, like, more than capable of doing this job.
Where is the snapper?
Right here, Chef.
All of you, come here.
Just touch that. Put your hand on top of there. Touch it. Touch it.
Don't you dare. I am so pissed off. I can't take it anymore. I've had enough.
Sorry, Chef. I'm sorry.
He screws me. You walk away.
Sorry,
Where's
Chef.
Your respect? Get out. Fuck off.
Can a couple of us stay, Chef, and try to do something?
Piss off.
Fuck. This is the second time I've got kicked out of a kitchen. You know, that really hurts my fucking feelings.
Red team, listen carefully. The blue team are out. You're now going to finish and sweep up for the shit performance the blue team have done.
Yes, Chef.
2 snapper, 2 New York strip, 1 port, 1 Oprah away.
Yes, Chef.
The red team won tonight because they got kicked out. Oh, my God, it feels amazing.
I apologize for the delay on your entrees. Red team's stepping in there to make your meal for you. So your entrees will be arriving shortly.
Now, it's up to the red team to finish service for the blue team's guests who are still waiting for their main course.
I don't want any bread.
We need food.
Come on, ladies, please. Come on.
Garnish up.
Okay.
Beautiful. Let's go.
Behind.
2 snapper. Got it?
No, it's nice. 2 snapper.
There you are, 25.
As the reunion committee applauds the red team for their entree's arrival, out on the patio, the blue team has little to celebrate.
What's up, John?
Not shit. You got your shit packed?
Why say that?
Because it's time for you to go, baby.
Me?
Yeah, you.
When you get on the real estate, then let's see what you're going to do.
I've showed my fucking skills several times.
When?
I ain't sent nothing out fucked up.
I seen you fucking hiding on dessert. I went straight to fucking garden, straight to it.
And went straight to it and fucked it up. Got shit sent back, went straight to fish and fucked it up. So kill that noise, man.
You didn't cook anything. Are you fucking serious?
You ain't in a position to say anything that anybody can't cook or do anything to fuck right. Not when I ain't never seen you do anything. You don't even know the fucking menu. You still don't fucking know it.
And you don't know how to cook.
As Monterey and Jonathan continue to battle, the red team has successfully completed dinner service, and Chef Ramsey has something special planned for the high school reunion guests.
Good job, the red team. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, seeing as it's Hawaiian night, I've got a little surprise for you to help celebrate this phenomenal 20-year reunion. Take it away, boys, please.
Dancing looks fun. I mean, I see you can even do it with love handles. I'm just saying.
Wow.
Do not try this at home.
That's our next challenge, right?
With the reunion ending on a fiery note, the blue team seems ready to explode.
We don't know what you can do because you ain't cooked yet. You came out throwing shots at me, I don't know why.
You'll be at the house crying because you got voted off. You'll see what I'm gonna do.
I don't see how you can throw shots when you only tossed a couple of salads and work a side dish.
Where I come from, a bitch move like that, you wouldn't last 5 minutes in my neighborhood.
Don't wait till I walk away. Don't talk that shit when I walk away. Now you want to back it up?
I said it to your fucking face, dog. I'm a grown-ass man, dog. Whatever I said to him, and I said to you in your fucking face. I ain't about that at all,
well,
dog.
Like I said, man, you might as well pack your shit, man.
They ain't never been me, ever.
Shit.
Ever.
Blue team, have you reached a consensus?
Yes, yes, sir.
Natalie, blue team's first nominee and why?
Our first nominee, chef, is Monterey. He was put on the fish station to kind of take over for Paul, and he was still serving up raw fish.
Blue team's second nominee and why?
Our second nominee is Paul, chef. He let us down on the fish station tonight, overcooked and undercooked fish, made us all get in the weeds and get behind.
Yep. Paul Monterey, step forward, please. Before I begin, I want to hear from one other person. Jonathan, get your butt up here. That's right. Wow. I'm seriously disappointed. Paul. That was one of the worst dinner services I've ever witnessed.
I'm sick to my stomach of what happened tonight. I ruined somebody's 20-year anniversary that they'll never get back. I feel that I'm not done, chef. I take full responsibility for what happened, but I really, really don't want to go.
I'm unconvinced. You disintegrated. You backed up the entire dining room.
I know, chef. I had the worst service of my life. I am so disappointed in myself that I'm literally cringing. Cringing of watching you at the pass and I'm shitting on you every fucking table because I couldn't get my shit together. I don't want that to ever happen again, and I have enough determination to make sure it won't fucking happen again. That's why I still want to be here, because my fire isn't out.
Paul.
Chef.
Back in line.
Thank you, chef.
I'm on the fence right now. Jonathan, are you a better chef than Monterey?
Yes, chef.
Why?
I have the communication. If I think it's gonna be wrong, I'd rather talk to my team and get it right the first time. You know, try to get a strong start, but get a stronger finish.
Monterey.
Yes, chef.
What have you got that Jonathan hasn't?
I think more experience on just the cooking alone and the language and the ingredients that we work with. I think I got more experience than him. Maybe knife skills as well.
Knife skills? Knife skills?
Yes, chef.
I don't know what he's talking about. I've never cut myself since I've been here.
It's hard to cut yourself when you just marinate meat all day and playing with meat all day, chef.
Okay. The person leaving Hell's Kitchen is Monterey. Give me your chef jacket. Your time is done in Hell's Kitchen.
Head up, Monterey.
Thank you, chef. It was an honor.
Thank you, bud.
Head up, dog. Good luck.
I appreciate the effort.
I truly think that Johnny should have been eliminated because he hasn't done anything since he got here. If I'd have known, you know, to stay in the background and not cooking anything was the key to stay in Hell's Kitchen, I'd have been dead dead from the start.
Doesn't matter what you've done before you entered Hell's Kitchen. It matters on what you do inside this restaurant. Got it?
Yes, chef. Yes,
get out of here.
Here it is right here, Monty. I'm still standing, and I'm still in the kitchen, baby. You're on the couch.
I know it's Chef Ramsay's restaurant, but at the end of the day, this is my prize. I'm here to win, and no one's gonna stand in my way.
I feel like Chef Ramsay's giving me the biggest chance in the world I'm ever gonna get. I gotta put what happened tonight behind me, focus on tomorrow.
It was high school reunion night in Hell's Kitchen. Unfortunately for Monterey, he flunked the test.
Next time on Hell's Kitchen.
I'm looking for greatness.
The pressure to impress Chef Ramsay.
Natalie,
chef,
come on.
Chef Ramsay expects a lot out of me.
Breaks the chefs.
You're standing there crying your eyes out.
In ways they've never been broken before.
Shut it.
I'm done. I quit.
Jonathan.
You can kiss my ass.
Jonathan.
and when both teams turn on each other.
Tommy wrapped Wellington.
Don't throw me under the bus.
I can't let this make me look bad.
My medicine's gonna be about 2 minutes.
That's what you called 2 minutes ago.
Who died and made her queen?
You won't believe what happens.
You need to work on your attitude.
You do too.
I'm not here to make friends.
It's a battle for survival.
How long?
I don't know.
Three minutes, I said.
Okay.
Don't throw it all on us.
Oh, my God.
All next time on a heart-stopping episode of Hell's Kitchen.
We're not done yet.